Hey everybody, what's up? This is Helen Simard. I am a Montreal-based choreographer and interdisciplinary artist, and I am most definitely a Fringe super fan. I discovered Fringe in 2000 when someone invited me to go see a show, and when I showed up to try to get in, it was sold out. There was literally a lineup down Saint Laurent and around a corner, and I couldn't get in. And I was like, what the heck is this festival I've never heard of, and what's going on here? What's all this excitement about? Well, I got to find out 2 years later when my name got pulled out of the hat. And I did my very first Fringe production with Solid State Breakdance, a little show called Showdown in 2002. And that year it was our show that had that lineup right around the corner. And it was so exciting as a young artist to have that hype about your work, to have people connecting with your ideas, to get such great feedback from audience members. And it's really one of the experiences that convinced me I wanted to be a professional artist. Well, fast forward several years. I've done a lot of Fringe productions, I think about seven or eight over the years, and Fringing has taught me a lot, you know, not just here in Montreal, but in tours across the country. It's taught me how to be creative with my resources. It's taught me how to problem solve. It has taught me how to hustle, because if there's one thing the Fringe was about, it's the hustle. And I'm kind of missing that hustle right now. I'm missing biking up and down Saint Laurent to get to different venues. I'm missing handing out flyers. I'm missing talking to people about my work in the beer park. And I really hope that we can get back to doing that next summer. But I think Fringe has also taught me a lot as an audience member, because it's allowed me to see shows that maybe I wouldn't have seen otherwise. You know, when you're only paying 10 bucks for a ticket, you take more risks than you do when you're paying 50 bucks for a ticket. So some of my favorite shows I've ever seen, I think, are at the Fringe. Just to name a couple, Baron Vaudeville on the Rocks, Co-Venture, Merkin Sisters, and most recently, The Man Behind the Curtain last year. Come on, guys, that was hysterical from beginning to end. Thank you so much, Sam and Eric, for that little gem. And that's what's so great about Fringe, is you can have an idea and just get it out there and get connecting with audiences right away. So I really hope we can connect again soon in real life. But in the meantime, I hope that you're connecting online with all the amazing This Is Not a Fringe programming. Get out there while you can, enjoy it, maybe crack yourself a beverage and sit outside and enjoy the sunshine. And just remember to keep on fringing despite the difficult times. And I just want to say to Kenny, because I'm his Fringe mom, I hope you're eating enough and getting enough sleep.